a band and choir teacher who has created his own in-house Jeopardy game.
That's right, Alex. It was actually a special event we did in college with one of our other dorms. We had an event called Nerdfest, and one of the things we did was we wrote questions for a test, and my electrical engineer friends built a buzzer system with a lockout, and then we hosted a one-day event where you took the test, the top three scorers got to play, we had all the categories, we set it up with a projector, and I got to play host. I think I was not great.
But I'm not too sure I approve of Nerdfest.
Oh, it was great.
As a designation for Jeopardy, but I'll leave that in your hands. Maggie Quaite from New York, middle school humanities teacher, who says her friends tell her she does a great Julie Andrews impression.
Yes.
In song or in appearance or what?
Not in appearance, but in song. Do you want to hear a very short? You don't want to.
We can.
No.
We can't allow you to sing.
Oh, well, then you'll just have to believe me that it's incredible.
Good for you. Ben Henry is from Michigan. You're on a Grammy Award-winning album, I hear.
That's accurate. When I was a student at the University of Michigan, we did William Bolcom's Songs of Innocence and of Experience based off of the William Blake poetry. It's a massive undertaking with enormous choral and orchestral forces. I am one of a member of maybe 400-person chorus, but my name is in the liner notes.
Way to go. That's hot stuff. I love it. All right. Maggie, you're in command of the board right now.
Okay,
start us.
Let's try recreational activities for 200.